Welcome to science class. In this class, we are going to learn how the food is prepared in green plant and what happens to the food after it is prepared. So in the previous class, we just saw how green plants prepare their own food. That means, why are green plants known as autotrophs? You better know why are green plants known as autotrophs, because they prepare their own food. Green plants are known as autotrophs because they prepare their own food. So the requirement for their food preparation is carbon dioxide. And from where do they get carbon dioxide? They get carbon dioxide from the surrounding air. From where do they get water? They get water from soil with the help of root. They get sunlight from the sun, and chlorophyll is present in their green part. And all the green plants, all the autotrophs, prepare their own food with the help of carbon dioxide, water, in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. They prepare glucose and give out carbon dioxide. This process is known as photosynthesis. Okay? Taking in carbon dioxide and water and preparing glucose in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll is known as photosynthesis. This is the equation of photosynthesis. Okay, 6CO2, that means 6 molecules of carbon dioxide and 6 molecules of water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, glucose is prepared, C6H12O6, and 6 molecules of oxygen are prepared. Okay? This is what happens in photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll forms glucose and gives out oxygen. Okay? Green plants, in this way they prepare their own food. So what happens to this glucose? First of all, this glucose is sent to all the other plants, parts of the plant where food is not prepared. For example, the woody part, the part which is incapable of producing their own food, just like root, flower. Okay, so this glucose is sent to this all various parts with the help of phloem, another tube. Okay, and they use this glucose for carrying out their life process. The extra glucose, the surplus product, is stored by plant in their various parts, which is utilized by us. They store this glucose by making starch in leaves, flower, fruit, root, and stem. This is utilized by us. The surplus glucose that is produced by plant is utilized by us. Okay, plants prepare their own food with the help of carbon dioxide, water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, and they utilize the food. The surplus food that is produced by them are stored in the form of starch in leaf, root, stem, fruit, flower, which is utilized by other heterotrophic organisms, and oxygen is formed as the byproduct of photosynthesis. See, all the components which I explained just now, that sunlight, water, carbon dioxide, and chlorophyll, these are necessary for photosynthesis. If one of the factor is missing, if even one of the factor is missing, the photosynthesis will not take place. Suppose this activity is chosen to prevent sunlight from going, so that we can know is sunlight really necessary for photosynthesis. So what does this activity tell? If you want to know if sunlight is really necessary for photosynthesis, the answer is yes. And it is experimentally verified. How it is experimentally verified? It is experimentally verified by keeping a green potted plant in dark place for 2 days. Okay, a green potted plant should be kept in a dark place for 2 days to de-starch it, because in 1 day plant prepares food for its next 2 days. So it is necessary to de-starch the plant. Therefore, first of all, the very first step is to de-starch the plant by keeping it in a dark place. After 2 days, take out the potted plant, and as the leaf is being sown, cover the leaf, half a part of the leaf, with the help of aluminium foil. Okay, not whole leaf, a part of the leaf, cover it with the help of aluminium foil and put it in sunlight for 6 hours. Okay, 6 to 7 hours. After that, what you do, pluck the leaf and follow this experiment. You can follow this experiment at home also. Just see, learn what how I am teaching you. First of all, you need to take a potted plant, okay, and as it is said, keep it in a dark place for about 2 days. Take a potted plant, that means the plant which is kept in pot. Okay, keep it in a dark room, that means a room where there is no sunlight, and de-starch it. After 2 days, take out the plant and select one healthy leaf, as I have selected here. After 2 days, take out the potted plant from the dark room, select one healthy leaf, cover the part of the leaf with aluminium foil. You will get easily aluminium foil. Okay, use that aluminium foil, cut the aluminium foil into thin strips and cover the part of the leaf. Put it in the sunlight for about 5 to 6 hours. After that, what you do, pluck this leaf. After 5 to 6 hours, pluck this leaf, the leaf that you have covered with aluminium strip. So pluck this leaf and do water bath. Now I will show you how is water bath done. Water bath is done by double boiler process. This is a Bunsen burner. This is a big pot. You can use it at home, a big pot. Okay, fill it with water and boil this water. And in another smaller pot, put some alcohol, because alcohol will prevent, sorry, alcohol with will take out all the chlorophyll from the leaf, as chlorophyll hinders iodine test. Okay, we are going to do starch test, iodine test. So by this method you will have to boil the leaf. Okay, by using double boiler, you do. This is known as water bath. This is a Bunsen burner. This is a pot which contains water, and this is alcohol. Do not boil alcohol directly on flame, because alcohol is a highly inflammable substance. Okay, and do this in the presence of elders or a teacher. Okay, don't do by yourself. Do it very carefully. Don't put alcohol on the flame directly. Always do this by a double boiler process. And after some time, this alcohol will become greenish and the leaf will become colorless. Okay, after that, take out the leaf in a petri dish after cooling it and put some drops of iodine over it. Okay, put some drops of iodine over the leaf with the help of a dropper. What you will observe is that the part of the leaf which was not covered turns blue black, showing the presence of starch, and the part of the leaf which was covered with aluminium foil remain colorless. That means no starch formation has taken place here. Okay, so what does this experiment show? This experiment concludes that Sunlight is necessary for photosynthesis. Without sunlight, food cannot be prepared. Okay? This turning of blue-black color so that starch is present here and this part remains colorless, that means no starch has formed here because sunlight could not fall here. Okay? Plants trap sunlight in the form of quanta and photon. Quanta means heat and photon means light. So, and they utilize this in making food. But this part, no sunlight was there as we had covered it with the help of aluminium strip. Therefore, no formation of starch took place. That means this part, no photosynthesis took place because sunlight was not there. This experiment shows that sunlight is necessary for photosynthesis. Okay. In next video, we will learn further. Thank you.